Munchkins and viewers alike, it's me, Munchie, and welcome back to the channel. Today is going to be talking about the rescue intake story of BMO. B-M-O. Named after the Adventure Time character BMO. For those of you who are new here, hello, my name is Munchie and I run a small animal rescue for hamsters, gerbils, mice, and guinea pigs, and cats. Not this one though, that one we keep. His name's Finn, by the way. I have Finn and Linus in here. So if you see the cats walking around, they chose to be in here while I was filming. So welcome everybody. Today's video is gonna be talking about special needs animal, and we've been getting so many of them this year. Before we get into it, the hamster in question is a brachycephalic hamster. And if you're not aware, brachycephalic is a deformed skull. There is the hydrocephalus, which is water on the brain. This can only be diagnosed with a veterinarian and with imaging. So if you come across any deformed skull hamster, which are Assyrian hamsters, because you do not see this type of deformity in dwarf hamsters. We've seen the biggest increase during the pandemic. So after rescuing Banana last year, which I never actually made a video on YouTube. So for those of you who are just not familiar at all, Instagram is where we share our stories. And not all the time I'm gonna be putting up rescue videos because there's just a lot of time, setup, planning, etc. And sometimes after these rescues, I'm so tired because we have to go long distances to get the animal and then come all the way back because we're out in the hills. We are not anywhere in the city anymore. We moved away from Seattle. We don't want to have that type of traffic. For our rescue, we are now specialized in brachycephalic hamsters, and our veterinarian office does see our brachy hamsters, which makes it easier to treat. These guys in pet stores will not get the right recognition, will actually get sent back if the pet store recognizes a brachycephalic hamster. And unfortunately, the breeding supplier who supplied that store with that hamster that was then notified that this hamster is a brachycephalic hamster, unfortunately, they send them back to kill them. And I did get confirmation from the Petco employee of which I talked to about 2 weeks ago. I just went into the pet store yesterday and I wanted some more clarification with her exactly. And yes, they actually have sent back some brachycephalic hamsters to be euthanized. But this is a condition that can be livable. Brachycephalic typically have 3 sets of symptoms, which mainly it's teeth, then there is also eye discharge, and then there's also breathing. Breathing, I don't really see a lot of issues with when it comes to our brachycephalic hamsters at the rescue, but sometimes you will hear sniffles a lot, and there's eye discharge, which unfortunately you cannot cure. The only thing you can do is just to have a warm, wet cloth and wipe away those wet areas to make it a little bit more cleaner for them, because unfortunately, due to the deformity, that's why their eyes are such open and exposed. They look like bug eyes. And there's also the teeth issues, where if you open up the mouth, because you're able to scruff a Assyrian hamster, they have the skin to be able to scruff and to safely put them on the back and do a body check. You can see if their 4 incisors, 2 top, 2 bottom, are very long, have broken off, are misaligned, are going in the roof of their mouth, etc. That is mainly how you can tell if your hamster is a brachycephalic hamster. It's the shortening of the snout. So if they do have a round snout that sticks out, you most likely don't have a brachycephalic hamster. But if they are squished in and they look like they're always doing a pout like this, and they have a pout and it just stays like this, you know, it's a nice little pout. But that pout kind of also indicates that, hamster. So this hamster is one of, I think it's 3 that we found on Craigslist, but this is the only ad where we knew they were a brachycephalic and we went for them because we have the care that they are required. They require vet trips. So if you don't have the money or resources for their vet care, then please guys, I know it's gonna be hard, but if you really see one, talk to resources that can help. If you don't have the vet bills for tooth extractions or tooth trims for these hamsters so they can successfully live, please don't go out there and get them yourself because you're just putting them in the same predicament as what they're already in. So if anyone's out there and in the state of Washington, because we've actually kind of made a shout out on Instagram that, hey, if you guys see any in pet stores or if you know any Craigslist ads that might actually show a brachycephalic hamster, then please reach out to the rescue. We might not be able to help them all. That's the thing. We've just been so full in the pandemic due to just everybody wanting to surrender pandemic hamsters, gerbils, mice, etc. And we just aren't getting a lot adopted out versus last year where it's just just like, oh my God, just everybody was adopting. It was crazy. But we just have so many and they're really hard to rehome. And it's just been one of those years that we wish were better, but we're hopeful for 2022 because 2021 just really messed up everything for rescues. It's not just our rescue, it is everyone's. I'm sure the Pipsqueakery right now is also hurting severely, and that's the rescue that I looked up to when it came to making my rescue. So let's jump into how we found Bimo. And I just want to make sure that it's very clear to YouTube about where we are coming from, because we have spoken so highly on Instagram, but not everybody follows Instagram. But if you want to learn more, go there. So the hamster ad in question says, Hammy the hamster. Hammy was wished for and arrived for a birthday gift. I am totally against people gifting animals for birthdays, except for when they have done extensive, you know, research and care, and people have said, like, hey, I got all the stuff. I think we're finally ready. I think I will surprise my daughter with an animal. I just don't like the, hey, last minute idea, let's get a hamster. There's definitely two types of people when it comes to birthday gifting animals, where it's just like, we've planned, this is a good day for a celebration, and it's a good day to introduce what she's always wanted and has, you know, researched and waited patiently for, that we are also in on when it comes to appropriate care, setting up stuff, what they need, etc. That's the time to surprise, not, oh yeah, my child's birthday is in less than 24 hours and I need a hamster now. So to continue, less than 5 months ago, so the people wanted an animal for the birthday. They probably went to the pet store, listened solely to the pet store, and then 5 months later, the daughter's like, I don't really like the hamster. Funny how quickly things change is what the parent said in this. He is great with kids who are patient and kind, no bites ever. And I do want to note that they actually had kind of an interesting approach to rehoming the hamster. They included everything in kind of a whiteboard style. So it says, Hammy the hamster for sale, $60 for bedding, food, cage, treats, hamster who is a long teddy bear. By the way, if you hear teddy bear, that is only a nickname. Syrian hamster is the appropriate term. And they said $145 value, which it is kind of like the kid spirit of like trying to rehome your stuff and see kind of the value of what you are selling for and how to manage money and things like that. I do appreciate that. But when it comes to the life of a living thing, I don't like that approach. But let me just tell you guys that when meeting these people in person and kind of showcasing them my expertise and my knowledge when it comes to hamsters, I actually educated them a little bit, and the mother was just so impressed. They're a very sweet family. It just was not a right fit, and they admitted to that. And the mother was more interested than her daughter, of which the hamster was for. Because this video is also for educating and to let you guys know what they came in. This is no way to try to shame or degrade the owners, because unfortunately there's misinformation piled online as well as in pet stores here in America, where our pet laws and our pet standards are much different. And unfortunately, I want them to be higher, but we're slowly doing that with our hamster communities online. California Hamster Association and Ontario Hamster Club. So shout out to them. Go check them out. Links in the description. So with this, it's just to let you guys learn. And unfortunately, because they were done with hamster keeping, they did not want any sort of advice. I gave them information, but they're not going to pursue hamsters in the future. But if they do happen to see this in the future, and if they want to revisit hamsters, I hope they do it correctly. So they listened, from my understanding, to Petco. This is where all the items have come from, was Petco. First, in the background, you have the cage of which the ad showcased. This is the Rat Manor. Rat Manor? KT Rat Manor. It's a KT rat cage, and you can identify this cage very easily. It's got this really big dish right here. No, no cats. Stop eating the oatmeal. Oh my God. This is why you don't foster kittens and also make a video when it comes to trying to showcase the rescue of this poor hamster. He's eating the little oatmeal because apparently Bimo really loves oatmeal, which is actually soft enough probably to be feeding him if he did or didn't have teeth. So teeth are very important for very hard food like shells, like peanuts and seeds. So that's why it's important, as well as for lab blocks. They would not be able to chew this if they did not have their incisors. Front teeth are used for chewing on wood and chewing on seeds and opening them up and etc. So that's why it's important. But anyways, the Rat Manor looks like this. It has one ledge, the bowl I described. It's the black base. That's how you can identify it. And when I looked at this, I was actually surprised surprised this is the Rat Manor because it's so small. This is tiny. This is not appropriate. But anyways, we have the bathtub dish ceramic that I usually put sand in for dwarf hamsters. We have one of the open base bottoms, which this is good to use because you don't want a closed off space. An open space is good. So even though it might be small for the Syrian hamster, they can actually make room thanks to the bottom. The thing that they definitely messed up on, because Petco is limited to what they have in stock instead of stocking a wide variety, they just have two wheels, their brand, which is You and Me, and this is the 7-inch flying saucer, which is not appropriate. Syrians need 10 to 12, but... Water bottle here, which this water bottle is not too bad, but this is typically what you would see for like guinea pigs. Not so much rabbits. There should be a larger water bottle for rabbits or bulls. I believe bulls are better for rabbits. You can use bulls for guinea pigs. However, I've seen guinea pigs soak themselves in bowls before, so just be aware. Oh yeah, there was at least one chew toy in here, which it does look like on the sides, right here. It looks like it was chewed a little bit. There's nothing else in here besides the KT Clean and Cozy bedding, which it looks like they cleaned this out before they gave it to me because I don't see any poops in here. But like Clean and Cozy bedding, which is all right. For brachycephalic hamsters with eye problems, we use paper bedding because we don't want to use woods, because woods can actually get very irritating and some hamsters are actually allergic to wood despite it being a safe wood. So we just typically use paper for everything, but there is different types and textures of paper, so be aware. Whatever feels light and fluffy should work, but just like when I tried picking it up, there is dust particles. It is something you can't really avoid. This is obviously dust. I could see dust in here is gray. Chinchilla dust is not appropriate to be using for hamsters. Petco does market their dust for hamsters, but it's not appropriate. It's very fine. It gets in their nose. It causes irritants. It could cause respiratory problems. So it's a good idea to use sand. Sand is sometimes coarse, but sometimes really soft, like natural sand from the bottom of the sea. That's stuff is great. So if you ever want recommendations, go to the reptile section, natural desert sand, or the aquarium section, which is natural sand. Don't get the wet version, all right? Get the dry version. They also have, unfortunately, hamster and gerbil food, but they're not using it. They're using the lab lock. So at least I'm happy about that because that looks like the KT lab lock. And that does have at least 20% protein. So I'm glad that he's not being fed this or wasn't fed for this for long. But this does seem like a big package, but I remember them telling me because it's been a couple weeks since we rescued him. Quote, he didn't like this food, but here you go. It's like when people tried to sell their hamster cage. My hamster escaped this cage, but here, take it. Buy it from me, please. It's so cringe when you see that being advertised in the listing for the item. It's like, you're not making me want the cage. If you said your hamster escaped. This is from Tiny Tail Lines. It is the plastic dome, but I always call it kind of like a UFO ship. And hamsters can use it, and because the opening is at least big enough for a Syrian hamster, I can give this to both dwarf and Syrian, but I see Syrian using it a whole lot more than dwarves. So they gave me some oats. They did give me what looks like a Tiny Tails ball, because this does not, yep, it says Tiny Tails. So part of the stuff is, I guess, from PetSmart, now that I realize that that is from PetSmart because it's a Tiny Tails line. 6.5-inch exercise balls. Please don't use this. Use a playpen instead. This has a bunch of issues, which I'm not going to go into detail with, but basically, they roll around. They can hit themselves in here. It's not really engaging in your hamster's activity and your hamster's life, so why use this? It's for your enrichment only, and I have used these in the past. I haven't had what people have described before when it comes to injuries, but I just don't use them anymore because playpens are more natural. You interact with them appropriately, and it also decreases the plastic waste in our landfills by you not purchasing a plastic ball. They did have the Select Seed treats, so right here from Browns, which is a good brand. They also got the hoops. However, I think this is added sugar, right? This one might have added sugar. I'm not gonna go through it, but some of these are still with artificial colors, like this one for the hoops. So I like to go things that look more natural and have natural coloring. And then one more, just one more chew toy. What about the condition of his teeth? Well, in this photo here that you are seeing, because I don't want him to struggle, when I have cats currently in the bedroom, he has his teeth. He still has them. Some of his teeth are turning white. That's more of a mineral deficiency problem, but we will hopefully start to see them turning a bit more orange. The two top incisors, they are aligned at an angle. They're not curling into his jaw. They're not pushing up against his cheek or puncturing his cheek. They are just misaligned, but it looks like he is still grinding his teeth. So these have to be watched. So he is gonna be remaining at the rescue for at least a month to make sure that his teeth are growing. And if they are growing straight, we will rehome him to someone who can give him vet care in the future and could take him in for teeth trims or extractions if they become severely misaligned. Some of these guys will need continuous care, while others might not need it at all because they might not have teeth even growing there. Sometimes we find hamsters that don't have any more teeth, and x-rays show that there's no teeth growing from the root, which sometimes is great because all they really require is a wet food diet. And Wendell's Wonder Formula by Cheeks and Squeaks is what we use for all of our brachycephalic hamsters. We haven't had any hydro hamsters yet, so that's why we're just saying all of our brachycephalic hamsters, and we want to offer you guys a chance to look into brachycephalic hamsters more by joining the Hydrocephalic Hamster Group on Facebook. Please check them out for more information. So today's video was just kind of a demonstration of what he came in, when we got him, where we rescued him, that photo that I showed with his face, that's how we identified him, and now he's at the rescue getting appropriate care. He has a very good disposition. He is active, but just active enough not to be so overwhelming like some female Sierra hamsters we are aware of. Oh my gosh, trying to tame female hamsters in heat is crazy. But when it comes to male Sierra hamsters, those guys are my absolute favorite. So thank you guys for watching today. Leave a comment down below about this rescue intake, what your thoughts are. I guess maybe as a general verdict, this wasn't the most extremely bad care, but the Rat Manor bars, I will say, bend very easily. So it's a possibility that he might have struggled to get out if he was actually very energetic or very bored. And that could be a very different story when it comes to the safety and well-being of the hamsters. So of course, in the future videos to come, I will be reviewing this cage as it is in its own separate video. So thanks guys so much. So if you would like to stick around for that video, please join the Munchkin family here at Munchie's Place. And I'll see you guys in the next upcoming video. Don't forget to check out the videos at the end in the end card, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!